Hi, my name is Hannah Slack, and I'm a PhD student from the University of Nottingham. And today I'll be presenting a poster titled Exploring the Development of the Forward Model System for Motor Control in Children. So, beginning with the introduction, the forward model is a computational model of voluntary motor control. Previous research has argued that the forward model is important for daily life because it allows us to differentiate between actions produced by ourselves and actions performed by other people. It achieves this by predicting the most probable sensory consequences of our intended actions. So, for example, if you flicked a light switch, the forward model would predict that you'll see a light bulb turn on. It then compares what we expected to see with what we actually saw, and if a match occurs, the action is perceived as self-produced. Previous research has demonstrated that children show immature forward model functioning compared to adults. This is argued to be due to increased noise in the brain areas that are thought to control the forward model system in children. However, limited research has investigated how the forward model develops as children age throughout childhood, so we hypothesized that successful use of the forward model system would be predicted by age. So moving on to the methods, in our experiment, 43 children played an online game where they were presented with two race cars and a set of traffic lights that changed from green to amber to red. Participants clicked the screen as soon as the green traffic light was visible. The faster they clicked, the better their chance of winning a trial. Participants' reaction time was recorded relative to the onset of the green light. You can see a demonstration of the task on the left of your screen. Participants' reaction times were classified as either the result of an anticipatory or reactive decision-making process using a two-horse race-to-threshold model developed by Burnett Hayes et al. 2012. An anticipatory decision-making process begins before the green light's onset and increases slowly towards the threshold required for action execution from the onset of the amber light. This can be seen by the orange line on the right figure. The horizontal line indicates the threshold for action execution. The two vertical lines indicate the onset of the amber and green lights. In contrast, the reactive decision-making process occurs in response to the presence of the green light and occurs rapidly to the response initiation threshold. This is represented by the green line on the graph. Producing an anticipatory response demonstrates effective use of the forward model as it shows that participants predicted when best to respond to maximise their chance of winning a trial. A stepwise multiple linear regression was performed to investigate whether age, parent-reported impulsivity or sex could predict the mean rate of rise in participants' anticipatory responding. So moving on to the results, the mean rate of rise in participants' anticipatory responding was significantly predicted by age and was not predicted by sex or parent-reported impulsivity. This suggests that as age increases, participants' anticipatory responding also increases. To conclude, we found that successful use of the forward model system improves as children age. These findings advance our understanding of how the forward model system develops in childhood. Thank you for listening. Feel free to get in touch with me via any of the places shown on screen.